Hello, everybody. Right, it's been a few days since I've really done anything on the shelves. I know on one of the previous clips I've mentioned that I might actually fit the shelves in place and then do the top shelf so I can work out which shelf is which. I did go to do that, but what I found was that putting the shelves in is a little bit awkward. So what I've ended up doing is putting the shelves in, working out which is which shelf, and then decided I'm going to go from the bottom up. So here on my workbench at the moment, I have the first floor shelf, as it'd be called. Now, this set of shelves, this shelf does need quite a bit of repair work on it. Now, just a couple of things to mention. I've got a screw here that needs countersinking more, but I had mentioned as well that there was one of the shelves where I got a big split in it when I screwed it in. I thought it was the one I'd already done. It's not, it's this one. There is a big split here, so I am going to need to try and do some kind of repair on that, because if I don't, it's just potentially going to split more. And annoyingly, the main reason that it did split is because I hadn't made sure the shelf was all the way down, so the screw tried going into a hole that basically wasn't there in the wood. The screw head did. So I've got a bit of repair to do on that, but also as I was getting the shelf out, that's the front. I can't see to my, okay, there's a knot of wood here that I'm going to need to sort of glue in place. That shouldn't be a problem. I had to do that on the cabinet that I did. I'm wondering if it was on this shelf. Oh no, yeah, there's a bit of repair work I need to do there. Yeah, so here there's a few bits of tidying up that needs to be done on there, really. I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to go about doing that, because it's a little bit awkward in the way that it seems to have its problems. So what I'll do is I'll wait until I've taken them apart to really be able to have a good look at it. But there is a bit of work that I need to do on these. I'm just going to be drill out, because I'm not going to need that at the moment. So just having a look. Let's have a look underneath. Excuse me. So there's not too much underneath that's going to need repair, and they're going to need to maybe do a little bit of filling on a knot on one of these pieces. Might need to do a little bit of shaping. And there's a little bit there that's just to be tidied up. But to be fair, most of it's not looking too bad. It is mainly a split and the wood up there. Okay, let's have a look at things. And what I'm going to probably do, something else I've worked out as well, is that when I put the shelves back together, I'm better off just getting it to this point without the front and the back on. Because then it's easier to get it in into the shelving unit, and actually to potentially to fit it on, because these will screw in easy enough afterwards. Okay, so there's not a lot that needs doing on there in terms of tidying it up. A little bit of sanding on there maybe. But then it's on the back, so it doesn't really matter too much. Might need to do a little bit of tidying up there. It's a bit dimpled but I would have to be careful there, because if I go in too much, there's a knot, and that knot could easily pop out, so I'll have to be a little bit careful on that. Got a bit of a split there. I may be able to fill that. Well, I will be able to fill that. There's a little bit of wood sticking out there. I can tidy that up. Now, basically, I'm not planning on doing any of this right now, if I'm honest. I'm just looking at it in preparation, because I have had to really take it easy over the last week. I'm still struggling with my knee. But yeah, there is a bit of tidying up that needs doing on this piece around here. Interestingly, near the knot again. It's going to need a little more sanding just to smooth off where I've repaired it previously. Yeah, so nothing too major really, it's just little bits. And as I say that, there's one bit there. Might be a little awkward sanding that one down. This one here, it has literally got a ring around it of a ring of depth. As I had said, if I can just do sanding to get it all looking better, I'll go with that. That one may be a little bit tricky to do. I can try it though. It might be worth trying. Just to tidy it up a little bit. I mean, I may even try getting my triangular power sander on that. Now I have got a dust sheet to come in. Might even have two, I can't remember. And I've got one coming. Went home base, do their delivery. I've also, I had to go to the parents yesterday to take them some bits and pieces. So while I was there, I decided to check if I'd left any varnish there, but also pick up some bits of wood that I need. Partly for this, but also for the table, because the big square, rectangular table that I've got, I do need to do some repairs underneath, and I needed a piece of wood for that, so I've managed to get that. It is going to need cleaning up and cutting down, and holes drilling in it, but I'm not worried about that. But I wanted to, while I was there, I thought, I'll bring my round table back with me. Unfortunately, the round table was just a little too big. I mean, I didn't try getting it in the car, but from just measuring, it was a little too big to get into my car. Now, admittedly, I have brought the leg. I say leg, and that's because it's one post with three legs. I've brought that as a pedestal, really. I've brought that because if I get this done, and I get my table done, and I had mentioned as well about sister-in-law bring in a little set of shelves. Well, that's these. I mean, fairly decent wood on them, and it's something that's a solid unit. But yeah, definitely needs some tidying up. So if I get to the point where my table's done, I've got that to do as well. And then if I've finished that, I've got the base of the round table, and so I've got enough stuff to keep me ticking over, but I've definitely had to take a break. I mean, it's probably been about a week since I've really done any work on this, and I really had to take that break because mentally I needed it, physically I needed it, and I'm still tired now. But Hopefully over the next few days I will start doing little bits on this, little bits of repairs. Now what I might do, because the first shelf took so many coats to get it up to the finished level, what I might do from here on is basically not record me putting all of the coats on, because it is basically, once you've seen me put one on, there's not a lot of difference. I might do a quick recording of like before and after, I don't know, but I'd like to be able to really shorten the videos down. I don't, unless people are really enjoying sitting me, sorry, watching me sit here in fast forward applying stain, I can imagine it's not very exciting. Now if I was to waffle all the way through, it may be a little more interesting, but then I think that first shelf I ended up with about 6 hours worth of footage. Now okay, we're in kind of lockdown and there's not a lot of people for people to do, but there's more exciting things to watch on YouTube than me fucking waffling on about staining wood. But anyway, as for doing the repairs though, I will record me doing the repairs, because I do find it's interesting trying different things. Now admittedly I don't have the proper tools for doing wood carving and stuff like that. I mean, there are other tools that I would I'd rather have for it than a Stanley blade and a sanding sheet, but yeah, I'm gonna have to cope with what I've got at the moment and just have to be kind of careful. Okay, so I'm gonna leave these for today, and yeah, on the next clip we'll make a start on tidying up these. And to be fair, I will do it where I do these three, the front and back pieces, before I take the actual shelf bit apart. What should I do? Now I might take all the support pieces off as well, actually. Basically do all the timber type, but that's a couple of steps away at the moment. Right, anyway, have a good one everybody, stay safe, and I shall see you in a bit. Hello everybody. Right, I'm going to try and get a bit of this done today, but it's a very hot day today. If I could reach, I'd open the window, but I can't reach. Yeah, so I'm going to take this apart, and then I'm going to make a start at looking at what repairs I need doing. I'll focus on the timbers, the studding timbers first, and then I'll come to the shelves at some point afterwards. But as I mentioned on the other clip, there is quite a bit to do on these. I need to get a tub for the screws. Oh. I didn't think I'd be constantly running out of Chinese tubs or food takeaway tubs, but seeing as I've had a takeaway for about 4 weeks and with no new tubs. Anyway, right. Be careful with the crack that's there, because even if I, when I repair it, that it still may split. As long as I don't screw it in this shoe. Sorry, it wasn't putting all the way, so I needed to check if it needed countersinking, which it doesn't. Stop recording there because I need to take a picture of this so I know which fucking bit goes where. Now obviously I didn't do that last time on the first shelf, so I ended up with it being a ball ache. Anyway, that's all. So that's the different bits of wood that we've got to deal with. It may have been that way. Like so. Okay, so these I'm going to put under the table and I'm going to focus on these to begin with. Now, the reason for that is because obviously these are all the support pieces. I was just wondering whether I may be able to fit these onto the actual shell uprise and then just attach these on. Maybe, we'll see. I might play about with different ways of putting all of this together. Right, okay, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to remove these and make a start on repairing these. I also may try on different bits, like for example on this, which is the front piece. I may just try carving in a bit, just for a bit of for the look, for the visual effect. Right, I'm back in a minute.